Alright everybody, if you have an iPad, an Apple Pencil, and you exclusively take handwritten notes, I have found you the only note-taking app you will ever need. Let's talk about CollaNote. I don't want to waste anybody's time with intros and we have a lot to cover, so let's start with the UI. It is super simple, but not like the modern, intentionally minimalist kind of simple. Instead, it looks like there is a lot more to come. Given that the first tweet from the official CollaNote Twitter account was on March 29, 2021, that is very much possible. Let's talk about organization of your notes. You can either start creating notes right on the main page or you can create folders. You can also create folders inside those folders if you want to have subfolders for your organization. If you want to move your notes around, you will need to enable organization mode. This mode will allow you to duplicate or delete your notes. And all of these organization aspects are also available in the iPad's file system, which you can access directly from the Files app. You can do that because all your notes are stored either on your iPad's local storage or on your personal account, which basically means none of your notes ever get pushed to a random server on the internet that you're not aware of. You are the only one in charge of your data. Getting back to the application, on the main page, you can tap on the profile icon to log into an account. When you create your first note, you will notice that you have access to multiple background styles to choose from. It will allow you to choose from ruled paper, graphing paper, grids, and many more. If none of those are your style, you can take a look at the artistic options or start with a blank page. Let's take a look at the menus and the buttons before we jump to the text tools this app offers. Moving from left to right, you have a back button that will take you to the main page. Then you have a hamburger menu, where you can change how your notes will update when you're collaborating with other users. Here, you can also enable dark mode. The dark mode on this app is way better than anything I've ever seen. First, you can convert all the UI elements to dark mode. But then, if you want, you can also convert all your notes into dark mode. After the hamburger menu, you have a help menu which features video tutorials for this app in multiple languages. So I'm glad that the developer promotes video tutorials from various creators on this app directly. Next, you have options for undo and redo. You can also tap with two fingers to undo and tap with three fingers to redo. On the right side, starting from left to right again, you have a microphone icon. This is where you can take notes while listening to your lectures. Your notes are then synced with the audio, which basically means you can choose to play the audio that was recorded at the time you were writing the certain portion of your notes. Then you have a plus button to insert items in your notes. CollaNote allows you to insert images, text boxes, emojis, and even stickers. Yes, you get to put fun stickers on your notes. Next, you have a contact icon. This allows you to have other CollaNote users for collaborative note-taking. And lastly, you have a button to organize, review, navigate through different pages of your notes. Now, let's talk about the tools you have access to. You have some regular ones such as the pen tool and the pencil tool. Both these tools are pressure sensitive. They allow you to change colors and opacity. Then there is a highlighter tool. You can change that in the settings to make it appear behind the text. This will make sure your text remains sharp and crisp even when it's highlighted. Any configuration of one of these tools can be saved as a favorite, which will be available for you on the right side of your note to make sure you have easy access to those. Moving on, you have an eraser tool, which can either erase by pixel or by object. You can automatically switch back to your pen tool or the tool that you were using previously when you're done using the eraser. This is a great feature for people who have the first generation Apple Pencil because they don't have the double tap gestures that the second generation Apple Pencil has. Next, you have a selection tool. This allows you to select your handwritten text and move it around and copy it to another note. Using this tool, you can also extract your notes as images with or without the background. This is probably my favorite feature because I start these videos with a handwritten flowchart and then complete it with typed text in a different application. Speaking of typed text, you can do that on CollaNote as well. When you tap on the text tool, you are taken to a separate window where you can start handwriting your notes that are converted into typed text as you continue to write. You can customize the color and font of the typed text as well. Then you have a ruler tool if you needed that. There's also a shape recognition tool, which can automatically convert your crooked and ugly looking shapes into their perfect versions. You can use the fill tool to color in those shapes or just any closed loop that exists in your note. I am actually coming from using OneNote as my app for handwritten note taking, and that is also a decent alternative. I have a review for that app if you're interested right here.